Welcome, my viewers, to the program of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. I'm your presenter, Pastor Florence Maina. I'm broadcasting live all the way from Minnesota, USA, a city called Champlain, and I'm by my backyard. And it is good to enjoy the seasons that God has given us. He's the God of seasons and times. The title of my message today will be, We Need a Light in the Time or in a Season of Darkness. Have you ever entered into a room and when it is dark you need to do something, otherwise you can stagger? And my words of reverence is just gonna be one verse. Imagine Psalms 119 verse 105 from New King James Version. The Bible says, your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for your goodness and for your mercies that endure it forever. As I share your word, use me as a vessel to be a blessing to your people. Even as many people enjoy this season, oh God, of summer, when the weather is good, I pray that nobody will be rocked out outside. At least to enjoy the beauty of nature and even to see the birds even flying over us. We thank you. We glorify you. Use me as a vessel of honor. I pray that I may decrease and you increase, oh God. I pray that this word may go forth as good seed upon the hearts of your people, as good ground that will be watered by the Holy Spirit to bring out words of encouragement and equipping and preparation for your second coming. I come against every spirit of destruction that comes to steal the minds of people. Oh God, take over in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Yes. Personally, I have entered into a room when it is dark and I have tripped over to things, and it can be sad. You can even hurt yourself. That is why you always need a light. You remember those times that we used to use the lantern lamp or kanyitera in our language? I don't know what you call it in your language, but you know about the lantern. And here in America, they normally try to put the lantern during summer and put it maybe by, you know, in the park area or in the backyard of, you know, whatever you'd want to put. But my main point here is, when you are in a dark place, you need some light. And that light, you can never get it these days. We already know from your education, no. You cannot get it from your money, we know, no. You cannot get it from a good marriage, no. You cannot get it because you have a beautiful wife, no. You cannot get it from a handsome wife, husband, no. You can only get it from the word of God. Hear me well. The light of the word of God is a light. It shall show you the way. When you are staggering in anger, the word of God will tell you according to Ephesians that be angry but do not sin, and let not your light be, let not your the sun go down on your anger. When you are in the darkness of judgment, you'll know that you have not been made a judge by anybody, but you have been called to love your neighbors. You've been called even to love your enemies. You've been called even to overcome evil by doing good. When you are staggering in the darkness of depression and self-pity, you'll know that you need to appreciate yourself and know that you are created in the image of God. This word, you need it. It is the torch, it is the battery everywhere. How about you are asking me, woman of God, my goodness, I'm a graduate and I was expecting to spend time with my friends, partying, especially when the weather is like this. But this, because of this COVID-19, we can only do the drive-through. Oh, you know what? God is still in the throne. He knows all this. Because your celebration does not come because of how people celebrate you, but because of how you have celebrated yourself by working hard, and your hard work will be rewarded. And the words in Deuteronomy 28:13 will be fulfilled, that we shall be the head and not the tail. But you cannot just be the head by sitting there. You have to do your homework, you have to submit your work on time. Oh, how about you are telling me, as a pastor in ministry, now we cannot congregate in that church building. Let me tell you, God did not call you for the building. He called you for the souls of people. And that's why I'm so happy that I was used to preaching in the media. So I continue like normal. So it is good that we take every moment and we celebrate it with joy. And we always know how to adjust according to the seasons of time when we have this word of God as a light. It's gonna lighten your way. It's gonna bring right in that place you feel like you are staggering up, and you're asking me, my my dear friend, Pastor Florence. Do you know how much I worked on my marriage and it ended up in divorce? My brother, my sister, let me tell you, God was not asleep. He knows you well. And as long as he has not divorced you, as long as he has not said, I'm done with you, that is where you have to get your hope, because God is still in the process of doing a new thing in you. Forget not the old things, but concentrate on what God is doing. One of the key things I like about Apostle Paul, oh, he had learned so many things in life. I think it's because of who he was. And he said, one thing I do, forgetting what is past and looking ahead, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of my faith. That was what was lightening the life of Paul. And he was able to rejoice and even said, I have learned the secret of living with or without. When I have less, I can be able to live well. When I have abundant, I can be able to live well. He had learned to celebrate every moment with joy. I'm going to repeat those words again. Can you imagine if you take it word by word? Your word. Whose word? God's word. What is it? It's a lamp. It's a lamp to what? To my feet. Why? Because my feet need to walk. You need to walk somewhere. And if you are walking somewhere and there is darkness, you need that light. If you are walking into that job, you need the right of God to give you favor. And you know that promotion does not come from the east or from the west, but it comes from above, from the Lord, our God and our maker. It continues to say, not only that, it is a right unto my path. When you are walking those dark moments, you are trying to invent in a new business and you have never been in it, the Lord will lighten it. That reminds me when I was a young girl and we would be walking through some places and going from valley to valley, you know, going for fellowship, for come togethers as youth, and we go places and we would cross the river and then we would pass through by a walking path, and this side is forest and the other one is forest, and you can tell there is a light at the end of the tunnel. My brother, my sister, we need to know that God is with us and he'll never leave us alone. Trust in him. I want to tell you, one of the key things I like about God is for every situation, there is a word. So that's why I would encourage you, in the beginning of everything that you do, involve God. In the beginning of your conversation, wherever you are, begin with God. When you are in that dark moment and you are feeling, I am so tired, I cannot even wake up, I cannot take care of myself. The word of God tells you, wake up, you slumber. You must take care of yourself. You must go, wake up, take a shower, dress well, put on makeup if you want to make, do it. Don't say, oh, there is nowhere I can go. No, you can go into your bathroom, look at yourself well in the mirror. You can walk around in your house, room to room, singing and praising the Lord and saying, when the saints go marching in, Lady Adaruma Kaigera. Oh, when the saints go marching in, oh, when the saints go marching in, oh Lord, I want to be among the number. Oh, when the saints go marching in, Makaigera gaine gweda gakarwa deho riria deru makaigera. And when they sing hallelujah, and when they sing hallelujah, oh Lord, I to be among the number. Oh, when they sing hallelujah, makele wa wira wa makele wa wira wa gaine gweda kakarwa deha makerewa wera Wow, you don't have to go to a choir practice to start singing. All you need is to make a joyful noise unto the Lord, and then you'll uplift your heart and you'll lighten your heart that could be full of darkness, of stress, and you're feeling no, like there is no hope. Wake up, stand up for yourself. Oh, yeah, there's a song we used to sing. Okira werugamie, okira werugamie, namagoro maku. You know, sometimes we self-pity ourselves. You need to wake up and encourage yourself. David did it. I will do it so that I can celebrate my moment with joy every moment. Not some moment, but every moment. When life gives you lemon, don't be stressed about it. Make lemonade out of it. I love you and God loves you the most. Remember, our main scripture was just one verse, the main one. Psalms 119:105. That's David who wrote that psalm, a man after God's own heart. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you with his word. And may you always look for the word of God as a GPS in your life when there is darkness. And you brighten your way. You brighten your outlook in Jesus' name. God bless you. I want to encourage you to subscribe to the channel of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. If you have any prayer request, send it via text or WhatsApp, and you can send me a message also in the messenger. Please, if I don't reply right away, I will come back to you. There is a lot that is going on. I love you and God loves you the most. Remember, these are not the season to stay in the dark. It is the time to brighten your countenance in Jesus' name. God bless you. I love you and God loves you the most.